Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
You have found it, the tip of the spear, the front line in the fight to defend human liberty worldwide as open, hardcore, textbook tyranny unfolds on a global scale. The United States is at the heart of that battle. Great evil, but also great good resides in this nation, as it does in every other corner of the world. But the United States is the hotbed. It is where the great struggle is centered. We're going to be live here for the next 3 hours. Constitutional scholar, pastor, patriot, former presidential candidate Chuck Baldwin's going to be joining us to talk about the NDAA, the increasing tyranny, the announcements that U.S. citizens will be tortured, killed, and disappeared here in the United States, the announcements that the United Nations now openly rules the United States through their puppet president. The Pentagon has lined up and sworn allegiance to the UN and openly stated Congress has no authority. Absolute, in-your-face declaration of sedition and warfare against the Republic. And those words aren't even strong enough. Understand, that's not rhetoric. That is the U.S. Code, the Constitution, Bill of Rights, Declaration of Independence, global precedent for thousands of years, right back to the Rubicon in B.C. 49 with Julius Caesar. How does Encyclopedia Britannica describe it? In fact, guys, print me that Crossing the Rubicon again, just that whole printout from Britannica. And Wikipedia just quotes Britannica in that section I was reading, where it said when he brought his military in and declared himself the ruler, he declared war on the Roman Republic. And there was a civil war, and he was successful and became Caesar, or king. Translates really to elephant. Caesar, Kaiser, means elephant. And elephants were seen as the symbol of royalty thousands of years ago. So it translates into that. And you saw what happened. Corruption began to pour in. And a lot of people say, okay, yeah, we are going into an authoritarian system. Congress is becoming ceremonial, just as the Roman Senate did. What's the big deal? Well, they're going to take most people's property. They're going to conscript your children for warfare. The police are fully militarized against us. Kurt was showing me video and news articles all over the country. Police are now wearing full U.S. Army uniforms. Just it doesn't say U.S. Army. So it's all indistinguishable. All of our own tax money to build a giant military system against us, drones, robots, surveillance, forced inoculations, banning of non-GMO crops, attacking Amish, attacking farmers, savage attacks on people selling cordwood on the side of the road, Agenda 21, rural roads to be torn up and railways to be spiked, just absolute deindustrialization, dark ages, by design, scientific bedlam. It's here. And the tyrants are testing. They're criminally training everyone to come before Congress and say, yeah, you don't run jack diddly squat. There is no oversight. And not only is the president a Caesar, that would be one thing if he was an American Caesar. You might get good, you might get bad. It's treason, it's tyrannous, Maximus, it's horrible. It's the maximum tyranny within the domestic confines. This is worse. This is a puppet tyrant, a puppet office of the National Traitor Council, the National Security Council, the National Sedition Council, and the Joint Chiefs of Treachery and Crime, all openly saying, we work for foreign powers. And who runs the IMF, World Bank? Who runs the UN? Who runs NATO? The open private banks. In fact, guys, during the break, print me an article. You'll see it in news or web. Just type in banker coup over Europe. And it's like Newsweek and Time are like, it's great. The bankers took over without firing a shot. Gee, can we have foreign bankers run us? They actually say that. Gee, I wish I had me some foreign bankers running me. It's fun, yeah.